the maxilla, mandible, clavicle. That's how actually can you do? Praveen, can you do this? Did you learn the skeletal system in this manner? Do you have this idea? Yes, Kaveri, can you do it? Just think, I'm not saying do it. Just can you be honest to yourself and to me? Can you do this? Think about and answer me.
From that day, you gave the homework about this.
I gave you this homework, Arohit. And yes. Arohit, can you do this? I mean, can you feel it? Can you actually make possible the names of the bones you are touching right now? Vivek, can you do it? See, this is the cranium. This is the eye socket, nasal bone, maxilla, mandible, clavicle. The collarbone is called clavicle, right? And then this is humerus. Now, this bone is humerus, right? How many of you have this skeletal system, the structure of this skeletal system, the diagram opened in front of you? Just ensure that you know this is humerus. This is ulna. There are two bones in the forearm. Ulna, radius, then carpels, metacarpels, and phalanges. Carpels, these bones are carpels, metacarpels, and phalanges, right? So this is how you need to be clear with the skeletal system inside your own body, right? Cranium, eyeball, nasal bone, maxilla, mandible, clavicle, humerus. Humerus is only one bone. Then we have two bones in the forearm. The inside bone is ulna, the outside bone is radius. Then we have carpels, metacarpels, and phalanges. This is how it needs to be clear to you. Then coming down to the upper body, that is the thoracic cage, we have sternum here, ribs here, also known as intercostals, right? Then we have the spinal cord, that we have the backbone here, protecting the spinal cord. We have the backbone right behind, starting from the neck to the tail of our body. We have a backbone, right? There are multiple bones attached to each other. Right, the vertebral column also called it is. Now, we have the pelvis, also known as pelvic girdle, the pelvis bone. Right, just look into the diagram which you have in your book and compare the way I am, you know, touching my body. Then we have ischium, pubic, coccyx. These are the part of the body which are really private and you can't, you know, touch or feel, and they are inside your structure, right? Then we have the largest bone of the body, that the femur bone. The femur bone is the largest bone of the body. The thigh bone is the femur bone, right? Then we have the patella, right? This part is called patella. Then we have tibia and fibula, the two bones in the shin part of the body, where we have the shin guard for hockey and cricket and football. Then we have, as we have in our hands, the palm, that is, we have the foot, the tarsals, metatarsals, and phalanges. So this is how it needs to be clear to you. I studied it nearly, if I'm not wrong, 22 or 24 years back, and it is still with me. I studied it once, but my teacher taught me that I need to touch the bones when I'm trying to think about them. If you can think about them while you touch them, you will never be able to forget them. Let me tell you, a question might arise. Definite question. In fact, I would like to shun away the word might. And I would like to tell you that it's an education when you appear that define or describe the structure of this skeletal system. Over there, as soon as you see this question, first draw a diagram of the human skeleton. If you have forgotten how it looks like, just think about your own skeletal inside, the skeleton inside. Just think about it and draw it first. Label it properly. Half of the marks you will automatically get as soon as you draw this diagram for the question when it writes, when you see, when you read. Describe the skeletal system of the human body. Right? Then describe it as you drew it. Describe it as you label it. While describing, you need to have one thing with you, which many of us lack. This is of your own in English, right? So did you get it? Anyone has any question regarding this thing?
No, sir.
Sure? Anyone? New children? I mean, Arohi, Arshian, any problem? Vivek, Singh?
No, sir.
Have any question? Huh? Okay. So may I ask you a question? Will you be able to answer? Right? You will be messaging through this app, the Google. You will not be pronouncing the answer, you're messaging me. Let me see who can answer it first. Which is the largest bone in the body? I'm showing it to you right now. Answer me right away. Message kariye jaldi jaldi. Which is the largest bone in the human body? You have 5 seconds to accomplish with the answer. Okay, the first one. Arohi Saktya. Femur. Very good. The answer is absolutely correct. The answer is femur bone. Right? How about it? Femur. Femur bone. And there is one artery known as femoral artery, which you will be studying later on. Artery mein. So, bahut khoon behta hai. Let me tell you, it is one of the thickest arteries in the body. Right? So, we will study it later on. So, now we know the structure of this skeletal system inside your own body. Right? Your homework today, one of your homeworks today, would be to sit down, close the doors, touch each and every bone of your body which you can actually touch and name it in your mind. Kya naam sahi se aata hai? In case you get the answers, and this is the humerus. Okay, what these are? Intercostals. Okay, what this is? Pelvis. Okay, what clavicle? You know, if you, you know, instead of arrangements, if you disarrange, you know, if you create a jumble of things and then try to find out. Okay, right? So that's how you need to be very clear with this skeletal system. Am I clear with this? Okay.
Yes.
Now we'll move further. Yesterday, Zaveri, please pay attention. You weren't there with us. Yesterday I taught you the synovial joint. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So the it's something which is related to sports. And sports and games are all about movements. Whether it is to grab a ball, whether it's to throw, you know, bowl a ball, whether it's to, you know, hit a ball, whether it's to kick a ball. Each and every aspect of sports is related to movement. And let me tell you, synovial joints are the kind of joints which are found at spots in the body which definitely, you know, provides you the definite movement which you require in games and sports. Spots pe synovial joints milte hain. Yesterday, maybe in fact, day before yesterday, I sent you a picture. How many of you did see that? Arohi, you weren't there with us in that group, right? Day before. So how many of you did try to locate the synovial joints at various parts of the body? How many of you did it? Did you go through the picture? Vivek Singh, your camera is off. Zaveri, your camera is also off. I'll complain this to principal ma'am right away. You people are keeping cameras off. Now they are getting on. Very bad. Zaveri, your camera is off. Vivek Singh, your camera is off. Why did you put your camera off, Zaveri? Every minute I have to remind you this. Vivek, are you with us?
Yes,
Vivek,
sir.
I'll be 5 marks. I'll be cutting out away from your half-yearly exams.
Yes,
why
sir.
Did you put the camera on?
Sir, बहुत दर्द हो रहा है सर ये.
Vivek, if you have problem, you can leave the meeting, but please do not put the camera off. If you leave the meeting, mark absent and it's done with. We are. If
sir,
you have
sir,
problem,
sir, I don't think.
Vivek, problem सबके साथ होती है. मेरा गला खराब है. पता? So it is not a problem. Please bear it. If a problem
sir,
you sir, feel is a problem, then it is a problem.
तो पढ़ाइए तो पढ़ाइए.
Okay, so yesterday, in fact, day before, we studied the synovial joint, right? Now, synovial joint is something which is very important to study when we are studying the
physical education, the subject of physical education. Why? Because physical education is all about games and sports, right? And games and sports is all about movement. And movement is something, most of the movement of the human body happens at the spot, at the spots where we find synovial joints. See, nature, or should I say God, has gifted the human body, you know, it has given those gifts. You know, synovial joints can be, you know, pronounced as gifts given by nature to us, that they are placed at such spots that which are the ones which are, you know, responsible for the movement in a human body, right? So I did send you a picture of a skeletal system with, you know, labeling where exactly the spots lie where we find the synovial joint. How many of you did go through that picture? I don't know. I send and you forget. Okay, so here I would like to tell you that we are going to draw a diagram of the synovial joint. And can you see this? If I'm drawing something, children, can you see?
Yes, sir.
Clear, nahi hai.
Then I'll use a pen. Relax. Relax. Can you see this, children?
Yes, the synovial joint.
Okay, the synovial joint. Now, the diagram or the figure of a synovial joint is more or less like this. See, this is the end of a bone, right? And yesterday we did make, you know what, a model. And the pipe, another bone. Can you see the other bone as well?
Uh-huh.
So, children, keep answering. Please keep your microphones on. Right. Then we have the other bone which we use is also right under it. And you can clearly see there's a space in the middle between the two bones. Right. Exactly, when we are studying synovial joint, we must remember that there lies a gap between the two bones, right? Then let me tell you, the two bones, the tip of both, they are covered with what? Cartilage. It's called articular cartilage. You can also call it just cartilage, right? Right? So, I covered the pipe with a rubber, you know, cap, and it can also be pronounced as the cartilage on top, on the tips of those bones. Can you see these rubber things which are placed on top of the bones? They work as the cartilage. See the cartilage? Okay.
Yes.
So, did you get it? Okay. So this is the cartilage. These are two cartilage, right? Okay, then we have one thing you would like to remember always. Please do that for me. Don't forget to mention this. That is periosteum, right? The periosteum, the paper which we used. Remember, a paper covering which we used. Periosteum is something which envelops the two bones together, like so, right? So this periosteum, when it envelops the two bones, you know, there remains a gap in the middle, which is filled with fluid, okay? And this is periosteum. Okay, this is periosteum. So, can you read it? Synovial joint, periosteum, right? This is the periosteum. Can you figure out periosteum? This is also periosteum, okay? And these are the two, you know, cartilage, which you need to mention, which you need to label. Now, just compare it with the model which we made yesterday, right? Now, the two bones are right in front of you, model-wise, right? And we have the periosteum. Can you find the paper as periosteum? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Praveen, is that clear? Right. So, we can find the newspaper covering as the periosteum. And I told you that the space between the two bones is filled with fluid. So, you can use an actual shampoo packet which is filled with shampoo. And you can place it right in the middle of the two bones, like so, between the cartilage, right? And you can actually cover it with the paper that is the periosteum, right? See that? Okay, compare. The fluid, the shampoo packet is inside. The periosteum covers or envelops both the bones together. The newspaper is the periosteum. And we have cartilage, that is the black part. The two covers, the two caps are placed over the
cartilage.
Vivek, please talk about only our chapter with anyone around you. Now to give it stability, right, I'm using two rubber bands, right? To give it stability, I'm using two rubber bands and I have placed two rubber bands on both the ends, thereby giving it stability, right? Can you see? Right? Okay. So this can be covered up with another piece of a sock maybe, which you can find as the muscles covering the entire joint. So this how the synovial joint works, right? The sole purpose of synovial joint is that the fluid between the two bones, right? That fluid between the two bones, it works as a padding between the two bones, thereby not letting them clash with each other and giving us a sense of comfort while we run or we work. Is it clear? So are we clear with the diagram of the synovial joint? Right? So this is the synovial joint, this is how it works, right? And we can reverse engineer the entire thing. We will remove the outer muscles. We can see the periosteum, that is the newspaper. We can remove the rubber bands so that we can find what is inside the model of the synovial joint. We can remove the newspaper, that is the periosteum, right? If we remove the periosteum, that is the newspaper, then we can find the synovial fluid between the two bones. And if we shun it, then we'll find the two bones have gap in the middle and each tip is being covered by cartilage, right? This is the cartilage, which I'm dropping now. So at the end, we'll get only the two bones with a gap in the middle. That's how we started with. This is the reverse engineering of the synovial joint. Is that clear to you? All of you, are you clear with?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I would like to show you the diagram once again. Instead of presenting screen, I'm using a sort of a self-made device, okay? So it is actually something I don't want to disclose. So can you see it now? The two bones, right? I must name the bones as well. So the two bones we have space in the middle. The tip of the bone is covered with cartilage. Both the bones are covered with cartilage at the tips. And the entire thing is enveloped by two sides, or all the sides should I say, with periosteum, right? And the space in the middle is filled with fluid, right? So this actually is the diagram of a synovial joint for class 9, okay? For class 9. If you want to go beyond this level, then it will not suit your syllabus, right? There are many other things which you will need to label as you gradually grow up and go to other classes. This is quite enough for you to understand what a synovial joint is, and the education which you must receive belongs to class 9. And please remember that the importance of studying synovial joint is all because that if you talk about games and sports, our subject is related to games and sports. Always remember that, right? And games and sports requires what? Movement. We require movement for games and sports. So all the parts of the human body, should I say the skeletal system of the human body, which actually are involved in movement, they all have synovial joints in it, right? 99% of the spots where movement is required, it is a synovial joint, right? So, are you there with us, Naveri? Okay.
Yes.
Praveen?
Yes.
Camera on. Arshia, your camera is placed in such a manner that I cannot see your face, right? So please place your camera in such a manner so that I can see your face. The question is, explain or describe why it is important for a physical education student to study synovial joint.
We have to write in chart or what?
Okay, it's important for students to listen. Let me repeat the question. Why it is important for the students of physical education to study synovial joint? Tell me, answer. Who will answer? Javeri, you give the answer.
Sir, so that we can know our bones better.
Bones?
Sir, sorry, sir.
I will
sir,
tell.
So that we can know our body
because
better.
Playing.
Arohi, you tell me.
Sir, synovial joints allow the smooth movements of the joints, and that's why in physical education the movement of joints and bones is very important. Because it allows movement. No, you said that when we grab a ball, do any movement for the body.
Sport is the word, right?
Yes.
Without the word sport, it is complete. Now I'm telling you. Wait, Vivek, you want to say something? Yes.
No, come up.
Vivek, what answer you are about to give? Tell me.
Sir, some football playing. Some football khelte hain sir. Uske liye hum log sir.
Vivek, no harm if you want to answer in Hindi. I know you have problems with the language. You can answer in Hindi. I don't mind.
Sir, hum log koi bhi sir game khelte hain, jaise football. So hum log isme synovial joint hai. यूज तो होगी बहुत इसमें ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट होती है. हम लोग फुटबॉल खेलते हैं सर अपनी लैग कहीं भी चलाएंगे.
ओके ओके फाइन फाइन विवेक सर यस सी ही हैज स्टार्टेड गिविंग द आंसर इन अ राइट मैनर. बोथ द गर्ल्स व्हेन यू गिव द आंसर राइट. वेट अ मिनट. बोथ द गर्ल्स व्हेन यू गिव द आंसर यू I know you know the answer, but you started with the wrong direction. Vivek has started giving the answer, you know, towards the right direction. Why? See, games and sports require movement, and movement is which is very very necessary for games and sports. And for movement, joint, the working of the joint is very necessary. And each and every joint where movement is made possible by nature in human body, they are synovial joints. That is the reason we must study synovial joint as a student of physical education, because our subject is related to games and sports. Are you getting me? Arohi, Saveri?
Yes, yes, sir.
The one thing I want to tell you, I know girls are more, you know, intelligent and girls are more inclined towards studies. But this subject is something which is related to games and sports, which are, you know, don't mind, do baby of boys, right? So, but it is true. So always try to orient your answer towards something which is important instead of talking about the unimportant things first, right? So try to pen down the answer in such a manner the important things come first, right? Instead of later. The target has to be sports. Sports require movement. Movement requires joints to work. Joints, wherever there is working, wherever movement is, the nature has given synovial joint at those spots, exactly on those spots, right? So it is important for us to study the synovial joint because we are students of physical education and our subject is related to sports and movement. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
ये एक पूरा सीक्वेंस यू नो देयर इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ वर्ड्स एंड चॉइस ऑफ वर्ड्स एंड यू नो पेनिंग डाउन द आंसर एंड मेकिंग सेंटेंसेस ओके सो आई गेस द साइनोवियल जॉइंट इज सुपर क्लियर टू यू ऑल राइट वेट अ मिनट आई एम वेट अ मिनट ओके so what I was trying to tell you other than the synovial joint let me tell you synovial joint is not a type of joint if some book shows that it is a type of joint I as a person with physical education since past 17 years would try like to pronounce otherwise it is not a type of joint it is a characteristic of a joint let me tell you what do you understand by characteristic the qualities no
it is a so that quality. Means every joint is a synovial joint when you are saying that it's a characteristic of a joint
no most of the joints are synovial joints related to movement I repeat most of the joints are synovial joints related to movement so it's a characteristic let me tell you type of joints are something else shoulder joints are called ball and socket joint right the ball and socket joint here this is also a synovial joint because it has the characteristic of the synovial joint so ball and socket joint is a type of joint whereas synovial joint is synovial is a characteristic because it has padding in the middle of the two bones right the fluid padding right so that fluid yes, remember this packet the shampoo sachet remember that between two bones it is there if it is there it is a synovial joint and it helps the two bones you know to move freely without clashing with each other that is the main target of the synovial joint you might have seen people coming to a doctor ki doctor sahab mere ghutne mein bahut dard ho raha hai and there are young people अच्छा डॉक्टर आज हम क्या करते हो आई प्ले फुटबॉल सो व्हाट हैज हैपेंड यू नो द स्पेस बिटवीन द टू बोन्स एट द नी इट हैज एम्प्टीड ऑल द साइनोवियल फ्लूइड इन द मिडल देयर बाय मेकिंग द बोन्स क्लैश विद ईच अदर एंड ही फील्स पेन व्हेन ही रन्स आर यू क्लियर विद दिस आइडिया डिड यू गेट इट
यस
ऑलराइट नाउ लेट मी टेल यू बॉल एंड सॉकेट जॉइंट is a type of joint whereas synovial is a characteristic of it exactly see the knee joint see knee is also a joint is a hinge type synovial joint it is a synovial joint but it is a hinge joint first right I did explain you what is a hinge Saveri you weren't there yesterday so can you explain what is a hinge where do you find at home a hinge hinge kahan milta hai ghar pe other apart from finding it at the knees and the elbows where do we find the hinge
so what
hinge hinge where do we find a hinge at home
sir door mein sir jo aise lage nahi rehte kinare se dikhau aapko
seeing before
sir main aapko dikhau
ha the door and the door and window the window palla has hinge exactly at which it moves right you might have seen two or three iron which are actually embedded you know on the main frame and the window or the door or whatever at the hinge
yeah,
that means but one side right so this is a hinge joint right it works like this and this is a hinge joint yet it is a synovial joint because between the two bones that is femur and the tibia fibula right there lies the synovial fluid right and exactly at the patella behind the patella there lies the synovial fluid and it is the synovial joint okay so are you clear with this thing
yes sir
did you get it
yes sir
okay so we'll talk about right we are talking about if you can see can you tell me which part of the body or which joint of the body I'm going to teach you by looking at these two Vivek answer
again
answer sir wo hai socket joint
socket joint ye kya what is this What is this Vivek? ये क्या है Vivek? Vivek, what is this? और ये क्या है? This is ball and socket joint. Ball and socket. My writing is very poor, children. All my life I have been a football player, so I'm so sorry about it. This is ball and socket joint. So the two spots at which we get the ball and socket joint is A, we get at the shoulders, right? And the B, the other one we get at the hips, right? The hip joint is ball and socket joint. The shoulder joint is also a ball and socket joint, right? So we get the, at the hips, we get a ball and socket joint. Another ball and socket joint we can locate at the shoulders. So can you tell me how many ball and socket joints are there in a human skeleton? Akal se jawab dena. Aroi, you answer. Use your head first. How many ball and socket are there in a human skeleton? Is it two or is it four? Is it two or is it four?
Four, sir.
Four. Acha, Vivek, explain. Vivek, you have disappeared from the vision of your camera.
Yes, sir.
I just taught you there are two ball and two places where we find ball and socket joints. One is at the shoulders, the other at the hips, right? So,
yes.
Arohi is saying there are four ball and socket joints. So, can you explain how there are four ball and socket joints in our body? Where do we find the four? If I say it is right, can you tell me?
Sir, two leg mein, sir, ek shoulder, ek hip.
Huh? Zaveri, you answer. Zaveri, how do we get four ball and socket joints in our body?
So there are two ball and socket joints.
There are two? Char nahi hote?
No, sir.
Nahi. Zaveri, there are four, beta. See, can you see this diagram right now? Can you see it? See, here lies one ball and socket joint, the shoulder, the right shoulder, and then we get the left shoulder, we have another ball and socket joint. So, do ho gaye? And yes, we get here another ball and socket joint at the hip for one leg, and for the other leg also we have another ball and socket joint. So how many of ball and socket joints we have in our body? Four.
So four. Yes.
Is that clear to you all?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, Vivek, Praveen, did you get how do we get four ball and socket joints? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Clear to you?
So when I repeat kar diji, sir.
Okay. Now,
no,
you are not clear. Vivek, are you clear or not?
मुझे clear नहीं हुआ है अभी.
मैं बता तो रहा हूँ. चार ball and socket joint होते हैं Vivek. चार ball and socket joint कैसे होंगे? Can you explain? No, you can't. I'm telling you. Vivek, there are two spots at which we get the ball and socket joint. शोल्डर्स पे और हिप्स में. तो शोल्डर, दो शोल्डर नहीं है? वन टू. लाइकवाइज वी हैव टू लिप्स, वन टू. तो वन बॉल एंड सॉकेट जॉइंट, सेकंड बॉल एंड सॉकेट जॉइंट
में टू होते हैं,
एंड फोर्थ बॉल ऑफ सॉकेट जॉइंट.
यस सर, यस सर,
राइट?
यस
सर. इंस्टेड ऑफ सेइंग दैट वी हैव टू बॉल, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर वी हैव फोर बॉल एंड सॉकेट जॉइंट.
Yes, sir.
Sir, your voice is not audible.
सर है ही नहीं.
सॉरी.
हेलो सर.
हेलो. वन एंटी शोल्डर पर शोल्डर को एक ही कहना है ना. शोल्डर्स हम प्लूरल कर तो ना उसको शोल्डर्स बोलते हैं ना. शोल्डर को नहीं बोलते तो शोल्डर. So, ball and socket joint is the champion of all dodo. No other, you know, this thing, joint can work. Are you getting me? Try to understand, this is adduction, this is abduction, this is adduction, this is flexion, this is extension, this is flexion, this is circum, you know, the entire arm is moving round and round and we can, you know, rotate it as well, right? So, all these movements are possible, not at only those parts which has ball and socket joint. So remember, ball and socket joints are found at four spots, two shoulders and two hips, right? So remember, they are the ones which are the champions of all joints as they can indulge in number of actions which other joints can't perform, right? So I would like to tell you that the difference between the ball and socket joint, just listen, between the, I mean, there's a difference between the two. This shoulder, ball and socket joints are, you know, typically shallow. Shallow means the socket is lesser deep. You know, the socket is here, right? And it is not that deep as compared to the socket of the hip, ball and socket joint. Are you getting me, Vivek? Are you getting me? The yes, socket sir. Is shallow. It is not deep when we are talking about the ball and socket joint of the shoulder. So
yes.
the ball of the humerus, it doesn't go that much inside. Itna andar nahi ja pata hai kyunki the socket is less deep, right? Or shallow. So though this enables one thing, this enables the hand to move freely, but it is weak. The joint is weaker in comparison to the joint of the hips. Let me tell you why. Many a times you will get that, you know, pop out of the shoulder, ball out of the socket. This is a problem. This is the dislocation. Many times it pops out and it is very painful. If we put our hands work too much freely beyond the capacities of human body, it will pop out because it is shallow and the ball is not fixed up that deep. But if you talk about the ball and socket joint of the hips, right, that the socket is really deep, hence making the ball go deep inside, making it lesser flexible, but it gives a lot of strength and stability to the ball and socket. So ball and socket joint of the hip is far more stronger than the ball and socket joint of the shoulder.
Yes, I got it.
Zaveri Arohi, are you clear with this?
Yes.
Anyone wants explanation in some other language? I don't mind. Vivek, Praveen, Arshian, are you clear with this? No answer. Okay. Are you with us or not? Please do not put your camera on.
Sir, I'm showing the thumb.
Good. Sorry. My mistake. Yesterday, I told you, you can... Without putting on your microphones, you can answer me. This is a yes and this is a no, right? Okay, now I would like to tell you the session is almost about to expire and you might have another class to go for. I would like to thank all of you, those who have come for this session, and I want you to keep coming. Don't miss any sessions now, because Arohi, you missed the entire, you know, first two chapters. Because you weren't there with us, and Zaveri, you missed the last chapter we have studied, that the muscular system. So don't miss classes. As soon as we finish this chapter, we'll switch on to this chapter number 2. We are revising right now for the half yearly exams, and please be careful that you need to be able to pen your own answers in your own words. That is the key to physical education, right? Thanks for coming. Today's homework, I would like to remind you again, that you need to touch each and every bone of your own skeleton inside and name it in your head. And tomorrow I'll be taking an oral test. Maybe the first 5 or 10 minutes I'll be devoting for this test. And I want you to be able to pronounce the names of the bones you have in your body. Is that clear to you? This is the homework for today. Thanks for coming. Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.
Please leave the meeting, everyone, one by one.